हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिसेस प्राची कलपांडे फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. सो टुडे इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वील डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 1, दैट इज़ टू आइडेंटिफाई इंटरनल ब्लॉक एंड पिन कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ FPGA एंड CPLD यूजिंग डेटा शीट फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट VLSI 22062. So we will first understand the practical significance of the practical. So it is regarding FPGA. So FPGA is a field programmable gate array. It is a regular structure of logic cells and interconnect which is under user's complete control. So this allows the user to design and program and make changes to the circuit as per the application. Whereas CPLD, that is the full form of CPLD, is complex programmable logic device, is an integrated circuit that application designer designs to implement digital hardware like mobile phones. So this practical will help the student to identify various blocks and pin configuration of FPGA and CPLD. Now next about FPGA is a field programmable gate array is an integrated circuit designed to be configured by customer or a designer after manufacturing. Hence field programmable is the name. The FPGA configuration is generally specified using a hardware description language similar to that of the application specific integrated circuit. So like FPGA is very much under the user's control. So the FPGA contains programmable logic components called logic blocks and interconnects to connect all the logic blocks. So therefore that is like a wiring. So if you on electronic circuit board, if you want to connect the ICs or the different components, then as you need a wiring, so there in FPGA there is a hierarchy of reconfigurable interconnects that allows the blocks to be wired together. Then logic blocks can be configured to perform complex combinational functions or simple or merely a simple gates and XOR gate functions. The most FPGAs, the logic blocks also include memory elements which may be simple flip-flop or more complete blocks of memory. So this is the logic block diagram of FPGA, as you can see here. The logic block diagram of FPGA, and as you can see here, the input output blocks are there on the periphery, and the inside there are logic blocks, and also you can see the programmable interconnects. So now as you can see, this is the pin diagram of IC XCS XC3S 400. So X stands for Xilinx. So now here you will see the pin configuration, the pin description of the IC. So IO stands for input output pin. So there are many input output pins. So this is general purpose user input output pin so that users can use it, and most pins can be paired together to form different input outputs. Next pins as listed here you can see. So these are dual purpose pins used in some configuration modes during the configuration process, and then usually available as user input output after configuration. If the pin is not used during the configuration, this pin behaves as an input output pin. There are 12 dual purpose configuration pins on every package. The next pins, as you can see, pin name CLK, DONE, then M2, M1, MO, PROG, underscore B, HSWAP, underscore EN. So these all pins are configuration pins, dedicated configuration pin, not available as a user input output pin. Every package has 7 dedicated configuration pins, and these pins are powered by VCC AUX. And also there are some 4 pins that are GTAC pins, dedicated GTAC pins. not available as a user input output pin. Every package has 4 dedicated JTAG pins and these pins are powered by VCC AUX. Then the next dual purpose pins, that is either user input output pin or used to calibrate output buffer impedance for a specific bank using digital control impedance. So digital control impedance, there are 2 pins per input output bank. Then the next pins are VREF. So dual purpose pin, that is either a user input output pin or along with all other V reference pins in the same bank provides a reference voltage input for certain input output standards. If used for a reference voltage within a bank, all V reference pins within the bank must be connected. Then the next is ground pin. Dedicated ground pin number, the number of ground pins depends on the package used, all must be connected. Then is VCC AUX. These are dedicated auxiliary power supply pin. So number of power supply VCC aux pins depends on the package used. All must be connected to plus 2.5 volts. Next is VCC INT. This is dedicated internal core logic power supply pin. Then the next pin, that is the pin that is VCC INT, should be connected to 1.2 volts. Next pin is VCC O. It's a dedicated input output bank output buffer power supply pin. Along with the other VCCO pins in the same bank, this pin supplies power to the output buffers within the input output bank and sets the input threshold voltage for some input output standards. Then the next pin, GCLK. It's a dual purpose pin, that is either a user input output pin or an input to a specific global buffer input. Every package has 8 dedicated GCLK pins. So G global, G clock. Then NC, this package pin is not connected in this specific device package combination but may be connected in larger device in the same package. So here you can see FPGA development board. So here on this you can see the 5 volt power supply, then you can see port 4, GTAG, mode jumpers, program buttons, RS232, TI Swift, USB, clock socket, system AC user input output header. Now we'll talk about complex programmable logic device CPLD. As you know, CPLD is a combination of fully programmable AND or array and a bank of macro cells, and the AND or array is reprogrammable and can be performed a multitude of logic functions. Macro cells are functions blocks that perform combinational or sequential logic and also have an added flexibility for true or complement along with varied feedback paths. So this is the general block diagram of CPLD. As you can see here, there are input output blocks, then the macro cells and the PLA or PAL and a programmable interconnects. So this is the IC diagram, as you can see, and the package name on the top, which is written, which is showing the package information. Now about the input output pins, general pins of CPLD IC. So IO stands for input output. Each external input output pin can be used as an input, an output or a bidirectional pin according to device programming. The input output pins of the bottom are also used for special purpose. Then GCK means global clock. Each macro cell can be programmed to use a selected clock input. GSR, global set reset. Each macro cell can be use this signal as an asynchronous preset or clear. GTS, global 3 state controls. One of the signal can be selected in each macro cell to output enable in the corresponding output driver when the macro cell output is hooked to an external input output. So this was all about the general information of the FPGA and CPLD IC. Thank you.